சில்ட்ரன், வாழ்க வளமுடன். ஹவ் ஆர் யூ ஆல்? ஹோப் எவ்ரிபடி இஸ் வெல் அண்ட் ஃபைன் அண்ட் டூயிங் குட் அலாங் வித் யுவர் ஃபேமிலி மெம்பர்ஸ். ஸோ லெட் மீ ஃபீல் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் ஃபார் திஸ் வண்டர்ஃபுல் சோஷியல் சயின்ஸ் வீடியோ கிளாஸ். ஸோ ஆஸ் யூ நோ வெரி வெல், வி ஹேட் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் த ஹிஸ்ட்ரி லெசன்ஸ். ஸோ நவ் வி ஆர் இன் ஜியோகிராஃபி lesson 2. So our lesson topic is globe. Before entering to the session, have you ever seen the earth? Some of us may have seen in some films or as images through internets and etc. But in reality, we might not see the earth as a whole, right? So in front of you a picture is there. Could you able to find what is that picture named to be? Yes, it is exactly nothing but globe. Okay, it is the right and also pakka model, three dimensional model of the earth. Why it is called to be three dimensional? Usually we can able to see wherever we are, whenever we are, whatever we are, we can able to see three directions: to our left, to our right, and to our front, but not at the back, right? So this is named to be three dimensions. Okay, so why I am saying the true representation? Globe will help us in better understanding how our earth looked to be. Okay, so before understanding the earth, we come to know about the directions. Okay, the directions on the ground are always shown with respect to the north, right? North in the sense are straight to ourselves. So if we know the north, then it is easy to find the other directions, namely south, east, and west. So there are four cardinal directions. We know that the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. If we stand facing the sun in the morning, then we face the east. Okay, so the west is towards our back. So the left hand points towards the north and the right hand points towards the south. So we should always keep this in mind, right?
Left, right, front, and back. Major directions. There are four main directions. They are north, east, south, and west. The four letters N, E, S and W represent these directions.
So, as an introduction, we live on the planet Earth, which is found third from the sun. Okay? Which is found third from the sun. So since the earth is huge and we live on a very small area, we may not able to see the earth as a whole. Okay, children? So but when we travel to space, we can able to see the earth as a whole. So in order to see the shape of the earth as a whole and to know its unique features, a three-dimensional model of the earth was created with a specific scale that is named to be globe. Okay, the earth, which is spherical, is flat at the poles and bulges at the equator. Flat at the poles and bulges at the equator. Bulges means slightly topped. So, the earth cannot be compared with any other geometrical shape, as it has a very unique shape. unique shape, special shape. Okay, so hence its shape is called a geoid, that is earth shaped geoid. So if anybody ask you hereafter what is the shape of the earth, you should not say spherical, it is actually geoid, geoid, geoid. Okay, geoid in the sense flattened at the poles and bulgent at the equator. Okay, so the earth moves around the sun. It also rotates from west to east on its axis at an inclination of 23.5 degrees. So the globe is also inclined at an angle of 23.5 degrees. So the axis is an imaginary line. Axis, what we can see is imaginary line. It is not actually found on the earth. Okay. So the first globe was created by Greeks in the year 1050 AD. So the Indian astronomer Aryabhatta one has mentioned in his book Aryabhatta Siddhanta, the star in the sky seemed to move towards the west because of the earth's rotation on its axis. Okay, so next we can able to see some lines on the globe, right? So they are imaginary lines. Okay, imaginary, imagined to be drawn but not actually drawn, right? So imaginary lines which are drawn on the globe horizontally, okay, horizontally on the globe and vertically to find a location and calculate a distance and time for easy calculation of distance and time in our earth. Okay, so these imaginary lines are called to be latitudes and longitudes. Okay, latitudes and longitudes. So latitudes, the imaginary lines which are drawn horizontally on east-west direction on the earth. Okay, horizontally on east-west direction on the earth, which is called to be lines or parallels of latitudes. Okay, parallels which will not touch one other. Okay, parallels of latitudes. So the 0 degree line of latitude which divides the earth into two halves known to be equator. So from the equator, parallel lines are drawn towards the north and south poles at equal intervals. So the latitudinal extent between 1 degree line of latitude on earth is 111 kilometers. Okay, so if you see the picture, just observe this picture for few seconds. So you can able to see 90 degree north, that is poles, okay, north pole, and 90 degree south, that is south pole. So at the center of the earth we have equator, it is the longest latitude. Okay, so these lines what you can now see is called to be parallels. So since the earth is geoid shape, okay, since the earth is geoid shape, it is the length of the lines of latitude decreases from the equator, okay, decreases from the equator towards the south and north poles. So the 90 degree north and south poles are not found as lines but as points. They are not, see if you observe this picture you can see they are actually not found as lines but as points, okay, just as a dot. The lines of latitude that are drawn horizontally between the equator, so the lines now you can see is drawn horizontally, right, flattened. So horizontally between the equator and the north pole are called to be northern latitudes, and those which are found between the equator and the south, okay, equator and the south pole, it is named to be southern latitudes. Okay, above the red line it is northern latitude and below the red line it is southern latitudes. Understood, children? So the lines of latitude consists of 89 parallels in the northern hemisphere and 89 parallels in the southern hemisphere. So 89 plus 89 and one at the equator. So one line we have equator. So totally we have two poles also found as points. So totally there are 181 parallels found on earth. How many parallels are found on earth? 181. 89 northern hemisphere, 89 southern hemisphere and one at the equator. Okay, children? So two points, poles, north pole and south pole. So totally we have 181 parallels found on our earth. Okay, so this is northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. So the area of the earth found between the equator, that is 0 degree, okay, and the north pole, that is 90 degree north, are called to be northern hemisphere. So the area of the earth from the equator, that is 0 degree, to the south pole, that is 90 degree south, okay, below the equator, so those part is called to be southern hemisphere. So the location of any country or place as based on this division of the hemispheres only we can able to say. Okay, and now we have important lines of latitudes. Okay, the earth rotates on its axis at an inclination of 23.5 degrees, this you know. So it also revolves around the sun while rotating. Based on the angle at which the sun's rays fall on the earth, certain lines of latitude gain significance. So those lines are named given here. Okay, 0 degree we have equator, and 23.5 degrees, that is 23.5 and 23.5 degrees north, both are same, that is Tropic of Cancer. And Arctic Circle we have 66.5 degrees north, that is Arctic Circle, and 90 degrees north, North Pole. And if we come down below the equator, so 23.5 degrees south, it is named to be Tropic of Capricorn, and 66.5 degrees south, that is named to be Antarctic Circle, and below that we have South Pole, 90 degrees south, it is named to be South Pole. Okay, so the sun's rays actually do not fall equally on all parts of the earth. Okay, as it is spherical shape, earth is spherical shape, so they fall vertically over the equator and slanting towards the pole. So thus all the places on earth do not have the same amount of temperature. So based on the amount of heat received from the sun, the lines of latitude help in dividing the earth into different climatic zones. Okay,
heat zones of the earth. Heat zones are divided as torrid, temperate and frigid zone. Heat zones divided based on latitudes of Tropic of Cancer, Equator, Capricorn, Arctic Circle and Antarctic. Let us see one by one. Torrid zone lies between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Midday sun never shines overhead on any latitude beyond Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. So torrid zone receives maximum heat. Temperature zone between Arctic and Tropic of Cancer and Antarctic and Tropic of Capricorn. Angle of the sun's rays goes on decreasing. Temperature between these zones is medium. Areas lying between Arctic and North Pole and Antarctic and South Pole comes under frigid zone. Frigid zone called as polar zone. Sun does not rise much above the horizon in frigid zone. So frigid zone is the coldest zone among all the heat zones of the area.
Okay. So here we have the three different kinds of zones. Torrid zone. So the region from the equator towards the Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degrees north, and the Tropic of Capricorn, that is 23.5 degrees south, it is called to be torrid zone. Okay, above the red line it is north torrid, and below the red line it is named to be south torrid. So the sun's rays fall vertically over this region and average temperature is very high. Okay, hence this region is now named to be torrid zone. And then the second zone is temperate zone. Okay, so from the Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north, to the Arctic Circle, 66.5 degrees north. So, and from the Tropic of Capricorn, 23.5 degrees south, to the Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south. The sun's rays fall slantingly. This region is named to be temperate zone. Moderate temperature prevails in this region as the sun's rays is slanted. Okay, so hence this region is named to be temperate zone. And finally we have frigid zone. So from the Arctic Circle, 66.5 degrees north, to the North Pole, 90 degrees north, and from the Antarctic Circle, 66.5 degrees south, to the South Pole, 90 degrees south, the sun's rays fall further inclined, that is slanted. Okay, so throughout the year, so the temperature is very low here, hence this region is named to be frigid zone. Okay, so some lines of latitude are also called by the following names in Tamil. Okay, in our language, latitude agalangu, longitude nettangu, equator nila naduvarai, Tropic of Cancer is named to be kadagavarai, Tropic of Capricorn is named to be magaravarai. Okay, so this fact we can get from Arviyal Kalanjiyam, from the Tamil University. Right, so with this, let me wish to complete this session, children. So thank you. Stay tuned, stay connected. Stay safe at home. Get ready for your test also. Thank you.